Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to East Chattanooga. Now, if you could look right over there, you'll notice that we've quite literally reached the end of the line, and as such, we have nowhere else left for us to go. And so, with that in mind, we're going to be turning our locomotive around on this 1960s turntable, which will allow us to recouple to our train and then allow us to head back to Grand Junction. Now, this turntable you see right here was built in 1916 by the American Bridge and Iron Company for the Central Oklahoma Railroad. It measures in at about 80 feet in length and weighs in at about 80 tons. It operated in the town of Macon, Georgia for the first 9 years of its life until it was then considered obsolete, after which it was moved to Cedartown, Georgia, where it continued its service until its retirement in the early 1970s. But the museum acquired this table in the early 80s and was placed into service on July 4, 1982. Now, although this turntable is nowadays motor powered, as you can look right about there, we can now operate this turntable with just the flip of buttons. It didn't always used to be this way, because did you know that this very turntable used to be powered by hand? This turntable is one of the many given the nickname Armstrong tables, as back in the day you would have had around four men pushing steam locomotives on this turntable by themselves. There was no such thing as a motor. Now, this turntable is obviously not motor powered, and I don't accept volunteers since there is such a thing as laws and legality. He will, however, still be helping me out, lobbying my good friend Jonathan's emotional and moral support. Now, can everybody say hi, Jonathan?
Hi, Jonathan.
Can everybody say thank you, Jonathan?
Thank you, Jonathan.
And before we begin, just a bit of a brief safety reminder. You may see that there is a yellow line in front of you, and so if you are standing on or above it, please take a big step back. Once again, please stand behind the yellow line at all times during our demonstration. Please and thank you. Now anyways, enough about turntables and more about locomotives. And today I get to introduce you to the locomotive that took you here to East Chattanooga and the one that will be taking you back to Grand Junction. Today, your locomotive is a locomotive I recently given the name of Blue Streak 2, but trust me, it has better names. This is Tennessee, Alabama, and Georgia Railroad, number 80. Number 80 was built by General Motors in Montgomery, Illinois, for the Tennessee, Alabama, and Georgia Railway in 1988. The Tennessee, Alabama, and Georgia Railway also is commonly known as TAG, or TAG route. This locomotive was among the first TV-30s ever built in America.
Weird, I thought they turned it the other way.
They used to turn it that way, not that way.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I do wish you over to the crossing. where you can see some steam locomotives that might pique your interest. Of course, if that's not right for your alley, you're more than welcome to board the train or visit the depot at this time. But once again, ladies and gentlemen, if you're interested in the shop tour, please hear from me at the crossing at this time. Please and thank you.
Yeah, they're leaving us. Israel.